What's up, guys? I'm officially commencing the road trip, leaving Waihin today, on the way to Udon Thani, the city of Udon Thani in the Isan province. This is going to be a long ass drive, probably the longest drive I've ever been on. It's around, I think, 8 or 9 hours. Some people told me it's 6 to 7, some people told me it's 10 to 11 according to Google Maps. So we'll have to wait and see, man. It's gonna be interesting to see what happens. Bit of uncertainty for me because the taxi driver tells me no quarantine required, you know, they're not gonna check, but we'll see what happens. Yeah, we'll keep you guys updated on the way there. We just stopped for gas. Here, the driver's been good, it's been very friendly. But yeah, just had some KFC, as you guys would have seen, filled up the gas, and we're just about to leave Korat now as well, so we'll see you guys soon. Guys, I don't know if you can see this rain, man. Look at this. We just stopped right on the side of the road here. The taxi driver just ran into a friend, but look at that, man. Oh my goodness. That's insane. Oh my god.
Hale, Waihin.
Wow. Yeah, Waihin.
Hey, non Thai, lai so dai lai. Okay.
Up here. I'm not exactly sure where we are, but I'll leave it on the screen for you. Quick pit stop, bathroom break. Look at that. What is happening, guys? Jason here, back again for another YouTube video.
I've just arrived in Udon Thani, right here in the Isan province in northern Thailand, northeastern Thailand. I'm here to show you guys my room. Just arrived literally an hour or two ago here in Udon Thani. Settled in after a very, very long taxi ride from Hua Hin. It took approximately 10 to 11 hours. I left at 9 a.m. this morning. I got here in Udon at around 8 p.m. So it was definitely a long day. One of the longest car rides I've been on throughout my whole life, but it wasn't that bad. We stopped at a few places here and there, so the ride was pretty good. I'm used to these long trips. You know, I've done a 14-hour plane ride before to America, so this for me was quite a breeze, and you got to stop at some places as well. So that was that. On the way there, there was a bit of an interesting little journey. You know, we're going through Koh Rat and Khon Kaen. You would have seen the roads, not the roads, but to the side of the roads, you would have seen the flooding that northern Thailand has been going through right now for the last week or so. There's been a lot of rain in this part of Thailand, and it's caused a lot of flooding, extensive flooding around here. But you can see the just the massive floodwaters. Yeah. Quite incredible to see that up close and personal like that, very, very close to the road. But anyway, here in Udon, it's fine. Udon Thani, man, I've been here two or three times. I can't actually quite remember off the top of my head. I think it's been two times. Anyway, I'll get back to you guys. I think it's been two or three times I've been to Udon before. Yeah, haven't spent a whole lot of time here. I have been here on separate occasions, like two or three days maximum on each occasion. So the idea for this time around is I've actually got the room here for 1 month. The reason being, I don't intend to stay here for 1 month because Udon is definitely not the biggest city in the world. There's not too much to explore, but the price, it actually worked out cheaper to rent it out for the whole 1 month instead of doing it for 1 week. So I paid for 1 month here, 5,500 baht. It is a very central location here in my room that I'm staying at. And it is close to Central Plaza. It is on a soi full of restaurants and bars and all that sort of thing. So you've got those sort of things here for foreigners especially. They like to frequent this sort of part of Udon. But yeah, this is where I am. I'm staying at the hotel. The name is At Home. You'll have the at symbol, At Home, in Udon. And yeah, so 5,500 baht for 1 month. Very, very good deal considering the location. And this is just a studio room. It's basically your normal hotel room. I couldn't pass it up, man. You know, it worked out being 4,000 baht for 1 week. So I thought may as well go for the 1 month. And I don't intend to stay here for the full month. Maybe I'll just store my bag here because I do have a big ass luggage. And I'll leave my bag here, maybe go explore other parts of Isan, like Khon Kaen and Koh Rat and Buriram and all those sort of places, but pending the entry requirements, of course. But yes, I'm here to show you guys my room. Let's get stuck into it. Okay, so this is it from the front door here. So it's just your basic bed here. I think it's a king bed. I'm not quite sure, king or a queen bed. I think it's a king bed. You got a bedside table on each side. You got your electric socket here, and you've got your wardrobe inside here. I haven't actually looked in here yet, believe it or not, but okay, so they got clothes hangers here, which is good, but I've got my own sort of things, but anyway, the more the better. You got your own little safe. It's not that big of a safe. You couldn't fit your laptop in here or anything like that, but you couldn't fit your wallet and that's passport, that sort of thing. And you've got space underneath as well here, which is good, but this definitely reminds me of the closet space that I had in Hua Hin, in my condo there at the room. So that's pretty cool. As I said, I've got my big ass luggage here, but I'll move that out of the way. But this is just your TV sort of area. And you got your TV, you got your mini bar fridge, and I think there's nothing in here. Yeah, you just got your two bottles of water, which is good. It's not even cold, man. And the fridge is not even on. So while I'm here, I may as well turn that up here. Cool. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be actually doesn't seem to be connected, to be honest with you. I'll have to check that, but yeah, I'll figure that out later. But yeah, you've got a mini bar fridge here anyway, and you've got some desk space here as well. And what else? You got a little desk here to do some work if you're here. You know, editing videos and so on, that sort of thing. Hey guys, how you doing? Got the mirror here. And you got the balcony here. Not much of a view. You know, don't know how you guys can see that, but there we go. So you've got the balcony out here, and it's got a little bench area right here. You could actually probably do some cooking out here. You got your own little sink, and you can probably, if you got like a portable sort of kitchen burner or cooktop burner, you could put that here potentially and start cooking. So that's very, very cool. You've got a chair out here, but it's a decent sized balcony. It's a decent enough size so you could sit out here for, you know, morning coffee or whatever, and you could do some cooking as well. I mean, yeah, if you've got a portable cooktop, you could definitely hook that up. I'm not sure if there's a appliance there, but a switch on the wall there, but yeah, you've got a tap down there. But yeah, over there is the soi with all the bars and the restaurants that I was talking to you about. So that's this room is facing that way. But other than that, you got Central Plaza also over there, the shopping mall. But yeah, not too much going on out there at the moment because it is quite late. So that's that. Turn that off. Is that off? There we go. Okay. And here we've got the bathroom. Hello again. So you've got your sink here, you've got your soap and toilet and shower. Very, very nice sized shower as well. Lots of space. Yeah, so you've got hot water heater, I believe, up there. And they give you your shower gel and shampoo as well, which is very, very good. Yeah, other than that, I mean, nothing too special, but it's all you need, as I said. If you're just a single sort of traveler, that's pretty much all you need. One thing, guys, that I forgot to mention also is just a quick tip. If you guys are looking at, you're in Thailand and you're wanting to find the cheapest deal for a hotel, if you're really liking a hotel and you see a good price on Agoda or something like that, I highly recommend following it up with checking out the hotel's website or also their Facebook page. It's a really good tip. With this room that I've found here in Udon, I actually looked on Agoda what the price was, and I then checked because I wanted to see more photos of what the room looked like. So I jumped on their Facebook page and I actually saw a post that they had a special promotion, the monthly promotion that I just booked here, the 5,500 baht promotion deal for the 1 month. So I wouldn't have known about that if I was looking on Agoda. So if you guys check on the hotel's Facebook page or even the website, and you'll often find that they have special promotions just on their Facebook page. So definitely a great tip there if you're looking for the best bang for your buck, you know what I mean? So even greater deals and discounts that you can find here in Thailand. So just thought I'd mention that as well. So that's pretty much the room here, guys. As I said, nothing too special, but yeah, it is a little bit old, a little bit on the older side, you know, but again, nothing too much to complain about. It is a very, very good price, 5,500 baht. I think that's around 220 Australian dollars, if I'm not mistaken. That's actually so good. That's the cheapest room that I've paid here in Thailand. And it's such a central location. You could walk to Central Plaza for like, I think it's a 5 minute walk to Central Plaza Shopping Mall. And you've also got UD Town, which is on the other side of the road. I think it's probably 10 to 15 minute walk. I'm not quite sure. I'll have to double check on Google Maps. But if you guys are coming to Udon Thani in the Isan province, definitely give this hotel a look. At Home at Udon is the name of the hotel. I'll leave the name of the hotel in the description box as well. But if you're in Udon, yeah, come and check this place out. If you're coming to plan your stay here, come and check it out. It's a great location. No swimming pool here, no gym, but it's just, you know, place for you to chill, and it can be your home base here in Udon. But yeah, what do you guys think of the room? Leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. But yeah, so far so good, man. Checking in was fine, the staff were good. I was a little concerned when they had asked me to fill out a form saying that one of the questions, it was related to COVID, but they were asking me, where have I been at an at-risk province in the last 14 days, I think they were saying. And I stupidly asked them, well, what do you classify as an at-risk province? When I should have just ticked, I could have just ticked yes or no, and I couldn't have just asked them. I could have just ticked no instead of asking them. Stupid me. You know, if I was from Bangkok, for example, I could have just said, oh, I'm from Bangkok, you would have to quarantine. You know, I said, so I stupidly said, oh, what is the at-risk province? And he said, Bangkok. And I said, oh no, I'm from Hua Hin. And I was like praying and saying, is that okay? And he said, yeah, no problem. Okay, so I was like, whew, very good. But other than that, yeah, that was a bit of a scare. But yeah, I sometimes am a little bit too honest. That's maybe one of my downfalls here in Thailand. But yeah, I could have just not asked the question and just ticked no instead of, you know, anybody can just ignore and say they haven't been in the at-risk province. But anyway, that's me for you. So, but other than that, all is good. I did say a prayer to Ganesha before coming here. I said, listen, Ganesha, please make my trip very smoothly with little to no hiccups as possible. That's what I always say when I'm going on these sort of travels, especially with the time being so uncertain right now. I was always very concerned. It's something at the back of your mind that you don't want to happen. You want everything to go smoothly. And this is one of those things, you know. I was perfectly fine in Hua Hin. I was very happy there, not gonna lie. But sometimes you just need to take that risk. You want to see places. You don't want to be stuck in the same place all the time, especially if you're on a special tourist visa like myself. You want to see other places. So that's why I took the risk and decided to come here, because you know, you don't want to be stuck in the same place, as I said. So I just went for it, got the taxi here to Udon from Hua Hin. It took about 10 or 11 hours, as I mentioned at the start of this video. If you guys are interested in how much I paid 5,000 baht, which I thought was very, very reasonable. The first guy I got quoted from was 7,000 baht. And then the next guy quoted me 6,000 baht. And finally, I knew a friend in Hua Hin who recommended me to a driver, and they managed to get for 5,000. Third time's the charm. I got the price, great price. So I went for it. Yeah, I was just considering all options, as I said in one of my previous videos, considering all options at this time. But I ultimately decided to pull the trigger and go north, up north to Udon, hoping that there was going to be no checkpoints, no quarantine requirements, all of this sort of thing. And thankfully enough, no checkpoints, nothing like that. And I'm here in Udon, man. Very, very happy. Very, very happy to be in this part of Thailand. I haven't been in this part of Thailand this year yet. So I'm very excited to get back to traveling again, man. This region of Thailand, there's no curfew here. There's none of those restrictions. Yes, you do have the restaurants closing at a certain time, I think 11 p.m. or something like that. For the most part, but there's no curfew and that sort of thing. So very, very excited. That's all for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel for upcoming videos in the future. And don't forget to click the notification bell to be notified of any upcoming videos as well. And be sure to click the thumbs up button on this video. It really helps out the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm very, very grateful for your time. God is good. Let the journey continue. I'm up north in Thailand, baby. Let's do it.